Please get ready for a dictation of transcription number 101 from Sir Kailash Chandra magazine. 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, there is no dispute in regard to the question that the working journalists had been suffering for long and that they need legal protection in their profession, as they were suffering. Government appointed the press commission, and as a result of the recommendations of the press commission, we are here discussing this bill today to safeguard their interest. Now our aim is to protect them from their employers. This bill gives them protection under the Industrial Disputes Act. As the operation for so many years of this act was in the hands of the Labour Department or the Labour Ministry, that department and that ministry are fully aware how it should be operated, as there have been lot of difficulties and lot of differences of opinion between one court in one state and the other court in the other state in regard to one item and one interpretation. The interpretation is required to be incorporated in this bill as to what is meant by a workman. The Industrial Disputes Act has given the definition of the term workman, but it has been interpreted by different courts in different states in different ways. Now again, we are dealing with two parties, and one party is the employer. In the definition of the employer also, we do not find if we can properly put the directors or the managers as the employers. Now this bill has tried to exclude certain staff and certain people doing certain jobs. Sir, the intention of this measure is to safeguard the interests of the working journalists by bringing them under the purview of the Industrial Disputes Act, by which they will be provided with certain machinery where they can go for the redress of their grievances. Sir, we must make sure that working journalists may not be defined as employers instead of as workmen. If, as we say here, an employer is one who is employed in a managerial or administrative capacity, there is bound to be difficulty. I will cite an example. Now, a working journalist might get 2 typists in his office, and he may have 3 peons. He may be actually a supervisor acting on behalf of the manager also. Now he is performing 2 jobs. He himself is working and he is also performing the work entrusted to him by the manager or the managing director. If such a person has got any grievance, he goes to this machinery that is to be appointed under this bill, and he is entitled to get relief. But as he is partially employed as manager, he may be denied that right. Therefore, I'm afraid that whatever we may try to do, we must be very specific in this matter. I think we should say that the working journalist means a person whose principal avocation is that of a journalist, etc., etc. And then they are also termed as workmen under the Industrial Disputes Act. Otherwise, we will be faced with that sort of difficulty as other trade unions are experiencing in their day-to-day work in the appellate tribunal or the industrial tribunal or in other courts. I hope that the minister in charge of this bill will consult the labor minister, who is an expert in this matter, as to how to safeguard really the interests of these people by putting a proper definition for the working journalists. Now I have got another point. Really, this should have been brought forward by the Labour Department, as they have been operating the Industrial Disputes Act. Under the Industrial Disputes Act, we have got some machinery which has got to come into being when there is a dispute. Now, under the existing Industrial Disputes Act, the appropriate government has got to order in writing to this machinery, as the working journalists are spread over throughout the country. I am not clear in my mind whether for the purpose of the working journalists this Industrial Disputes Act will be operated by the central government or by the state governments. Both the central and the state governments have their own machinery. From the Chief Labour Commissioner to the Reconciliation Officer, the Government of India has got a set of machinery throughout the country, and again the state governments have got their own Labour Commissioner and other officers. I want that also must be specifically provided in this bill, as to whether they have got to go to the central government or to the state governments for the redress of their grievances. Now, the tribunals are not permitted to undertake any case as soon as it is referred by either of the parties, unless it is specifically ordered by the appropriate government. Now, my own opinion is this, that for the time being, it should be operated by the Labour Ministry of the central government. Neither the Information and Broadcasting Ministry nor the state governments should operate this, because it is a new thing incorporated by the central government, and the Government of India knows what for they are coming forward with this piece of legislation. I want that the Information Ministry should hand over this business to the Labour Ministry, which should operate this through its own machinery. Sir, anyone who knows anything of journalism in this country will welcome the protection that this bill gives to working journalists. There is no doubt that their present lot is a hard one, and that it is difficult sometimes even for the best of them to discharge their duties honestly. But the remarks made by my honourable friend make me anxious to understand the scope of the bill. My honourable friend spoke of the protection given to editors who expressed their views freely even though they may be unpalatable to the proprietors of their papers. Sir, is it really the object of the bill to make the working journalists to decide the policy of the paper to which they are now attached? Stop.